Hello friends, myself Dr. Sonali Rohan Bendre. I am assistant professor in the Department of Homeopathic Materia Medica in Motiwala Homeopathic Medical College and Hospital, Nasik. Today we will going to discuss about Antim Tartarica. First we will going to see the learning objectives. First objective is that to explain the sphere of action and pathogenesis of the remedy and some characteristic symptom of the remedy. Second one is how one can observe and take symptoms from the patient by learning this remedy. Third one is to apply disease knowledge and remedy knowledge to a patient for cure. So Antim Tartaricum, the common names are tartar emetics, tartarate of antimony and potash. Tartar emetic is the name because in ancient era the doctors were using this element or the compound as a emetics. Now the remedy is suited to the catarrh patients in broken down constitution, in feeble children, in old people where we hear a coarse rattling and bubbling in the chest. Basically this remedy is having a catarrh inflammation and the gradual phase or pace of the disease. In early stage in the catarrh inflammation, the remedies are aconite, belladonna, etc., who are having a very sudden onset. But in Antim Tart, there is gradual onset. And in the initial stage of any catarrhal condition, there is formation of mucus and the expectorations are there. But Antim Tart comes in a picture when there is mucus production is very high, but the expectoration are very less, and it is because the patient is very very feeble and prostrated. Because of the prostration, patient is unable to throw out this mucus out of the body. So adapted to the torpid, that means very sluggish people, the sluggish is because of the feebleness and prostration, phlegmatic person and the hydrogenite constitution. Hydrogenite constitution, we have already seen in Natrum Sulph patient also. Hydrogenite constitution belongs to those people who are generally affected by the humidity of the atmosphere, specifically in rainy weather and rainy season, which is profoundly acting on the respiratory tract and the mucus production ultimately. The main sphere of action of this remedy is respiratory system, gastrointestinal tract, skin and urinary tract. But the main symptoms, main systems are respiratory system and gastrointestinal tract. The pathogenesis, the main key feature of this remedy is the pneumogastric nerve. Through the pneumogastric nerve, it depresses the respiration and circulation, thus producing the keynote of the remedy, which when the patient coughs, there appears to be a large collection of the mucus in the bronchi. It seems as if much would be expectorated, but nothing comes out. As the pneumogastric nerve is affected, which is supplying the nerve supply to the respiratory organs and the GI organs specifically. On GI organ, it will going to produce the vomiting and diarrhea. And respiratory organs, it will going to produce catarrhal inflammation. In this remedy, diseases originating from exposure in damp pavement and cellars. Other remedies are arsenic and terebinthina. You can see in this picture the dampness of the room, and that dampness is really going to affect the hydrogenite constitution patient, and that's why there is catarrhal inflammation. So the elements from damp basement and cellar. As you have seen many of the patients in ICU which are on a ventilator, or you have seen that these patients are having one pulso oximeter, and that oximeter is really showing the oxygen saturation of that person's body. When the alveoli is completely filled with the mucus, you can imagine the condition of that patient. The oxygen saturation is really dropped down, and because of this oxygen drop down, the drowsiness is produced, and that's why patient is becoming really drowsy and there is great sleepiness or irresistible desire, inclination to sleep, with nearly all complaints you will going to see. Other remedies are Nux, Moshata and Opium, where the sleep is really irresistible. In this GIF, you can see the baby is completely drowsy. And in this second image, this is particularly for you. After post-lunch sessions, your condition is seemingly like this, as the heaviness of the stomach. Child clings to those around, wants to be carried, cries, whines if anyone touches it, will not let you feel the pulse. Other remedies are Antimicrude and Sanicula. This child is already irritable and he is very small. He cannot narrate the symptom. Though the chest is filled with the mucus, he is unable to expectorate. That's why he is always clings to the person and want to carry here and there. But he will not going to tolerate the approach of any person towards him, as you have seen this in Antimicrudum also. Patient is very touchy and patient doesn't want to touch him because patient needs solitude. Face is very cold, blue, pale, covered with a cold sweat. You can see over here the cyanotic baby and the pink baby. The pink baby is a normal child, and where the cyanotic baby, where the cyanosis is there, you can see the puffiness of the face in that baby and cyanosis in particularly. Okay, so we'll move further. The tongue is very, very characteristic in this patient, as the tongue in Antimicrudum also. The tongue is coated pasty white, thick white with reddened papillae and red edges, red streaks, very red, dry in the middle. And there is extraordinary craving for apples like Antimicrude. But the tongue is very, very characteristic, and you should never forget to examine the tongue of the patient. The tongue is very important while selecting the remedy. As here in Antimicrude, the tongue is how the tongue? The tongue is pasty white with raised papillae, which are raised, red. The margins are also red and the red streaks in the middle. Vomiting, as we have seen, tartar emetic, its common name. In any position except lying on a right side, which is very characteristic, until he faints. Vomiting is there until the patient is not getting faint, followed by drowsiness and prostration of cholera morbus with diarrhea and cold sweat. A dose after each attack you should give. Other remedy is Veratrum Album, where you can see the same symptom like cholera morbus, where there is cold clammy skin and cold perspiration throughout the body with rice watery stool with vomiting. The particular and most characteristic symptom again in this remedy is thirstlessness. Though the patient is having tremendous vomiting, catarrhal inflammation, but patient is completely thirstless. You should remember one thing. If the patient is thirsty, the remedy will be changed. If the patient is completely thirstless, then only Antimicrude is the remedy. Asphyxia. Specifically mechanical, as apparent death from drowning, from mucus in the bronchi, from impending paralysis of the lung, from foreign bodies in larynx or trachea with drowsiness and coma. So, mainly asphyxia. You can see in this image, there is really a air hunger and gasping for the breath. The patient is really having air hunger and he is unable to breathe properly. So, here all the causes are covered in this remedy, as the drowning, as because of the foreign bodies and the mucus accumulation. So you should think Antimicrude in a very, very serious cases who are bedridden in ICU, who are really in a stage where patient is at the last stage. You should think of this remedy when you are entering in the room of the patient and the smell is really very very pungent. As you have seen in arsenic album, as you are going to enter in the room, there is really very foul smell. But in anti-tart, there is pungent kind of smell, and the relatives are really in anxiety and anxious. Nurse is just going here and there. He is very anxious because the patient is at the last stage. And in this stage, you should be a best thinker and you should give a quick prescription as early as possible so that patient can survive. As now the picture is swine flu, COVID-19, etc., etc. These diseases are causing a pneumonia which is really life-threatening. So in these conditions, you should think of antitartarical. We'll move further. This remedy is very useful. Child at birth, born pain, breathlessness and gasping is there. Asphyxia, neonatum specifically, relieves the death rattle. Icterus with pneumonia, especially of the right lung. Right side of the lung is tremendously affected by this remedy, and you should not forget this. As the mucus or mucus is filled in the alveoli and the saturation is dropping down, patient is going under the carbonic acidosis, and that's why the carbon dioxide level is increased in the body, and that's why patient may go into coma. And in such cases, for prolonged labor, if the baby is not treated, asphyxia, patient can develop mental retardation for lifelong. So you should be very careful by selecting a remedy. In asphyxia neonatum, one of the remedy is antitartarical. Fever, which is a common condition in this infection, but the fever in antitart is again characteristic. There is tremendous coldness and trembling, and the chilliness is there, profound chilliness. The intense heat is there, copious perspiration is there. The skin is cold and clammy because of the cold sweat. With great faintness, intermittent fever with lethargic condition. The fever is not very easy. The fever is always beyond 103-104. Because inflammation is very very severe, and you should consider this remedy again with cold clammy sweat. Now we'll see at last the modalities of this remedy. This remedy is aggravated in damp cold weather, lying down at night. So as soon as the patient will going to lie down, there is again a cough, and which is so violent and severe, but no expectoration. Warmth of the room, change of weather in the spring. As the weather will going to change specifically to the spring, the patient will going to be aggravated. Other remedy is Kali Sulf and Natrum Sulf. I want to tell you the main difference between Kali Sulf and Antim Tartaricum is, in Antim Tart there is profound weakness, where in Kali Sulf the patient is again having change of weather aggravation, and he will going to develop a small rattling in the chest. But the patient is very playful, he will going to play, he will going to enjoy his day. But antitart will not. Antitart wants solitude, want to stay at one place, and again moaning and groaning is there. And patient is very very prostrated, opposite of Kali Sulf. Ambliteration by cold open air, sitting upright. One more thing, sitting upright is ambliteration for antitartarical. But if the patient will going to bend forward, it is again aggravating factor for this remedy, as it will going to induce the vomiting. Expectorating, patient is feeling better, but there is no expectoration. That's why in initial stages, patient is feeling better, but afterwards the patient is not feeling better as the expectoration are vanishes. Lying on the right side, patient is having vomiting in every position except on lying on the right side. You should remember this symptom because it is very very characteristic. When patient will going to lie on the right side, he will not going to have any kind of vomiting. Relationship, it antidotes pulsatilla and sepia, and compared to Kali Sulf and Ipecac, as Ipecac is also having nausea constant. Well, we have seen that the rattling throughout the remedy but I want to show how is this rattling is. So we'll just listen this video, you can understand what is exactly the rattling.
Sometimes crackles are produced by the accumulation of secretions in the airway. When the secretions are profuse, the crackles can be heard over the mouth as well as over the chest wall, a sign known to ancient physicians as the death rattle. You will now hear a death rattle in a dying patient over the mouth.
Exactly. You should not leave any opportunity to examine a patient thoroughly. And if you want to listen this rattling, you can do one thing. Just place the earpiece of the stetho in your ear and take a bunch of hair and just rub it over it. You will going to hear the rattling, the coarse rattling which is present through and through. Don't forget the right side is mainly affected. In urinary organ, it is producing anuria and burning micturition by passing urine, and on skin it is producing a smallpox like eruptions, vesicles, etc., which are very very common in viral infections. As soon as the fever is there, eruptions are there. Thank you so much for listening to me patiently. And I hope that you will going to read this remedy from Class Materia Medica, Keynes Materia Medica, Allen's keynote for further preparation. Thank you so much.